COVID vaccine.
Vaccines.
Get the vaccine.
Have at least one vaccine.
There are consequences if you don't.
Get the vaccine.
Getting vaccinated. Get the shot.
Vaccine misinformation.
Vaccinated.
Vaccinated.
Be vaccinated.
Fully vaccinated.
You need to get the vaccine.
If you're around all vaccinated people all the time, that's great.
You must
say yes to vaccines.
COVID and its vaccines. It's so obvious. You have to get the vaccine. Meditate on the simple fucking fact that you have to get vaccinated.
Google to CNN and United Airlines have made the vaccine compulsory for staff.
This is not a compulsory vaccination program.
New South Wales made vaccines mandatory in August.
The vaccine.
Good evening. Get the jab or risk losing your job.
COVID-19 vaccines should become mandatory.
By making life for the non-vaccinated more complicated.
Vaccines for some professions should be mandatory.
I've just had a vaccine for COVID. Not many people know that.
The vaccine.
Can I get the vaccine? You can't go to the supermarket. Don't have the vaccine, you don't show it, can't go to the ball game. Don't have the vaccine, can't go to work. Don't have the vaccine, can't come here. No shirt, no shoes, no service. That's what I think we should be right now. Because we continue to waste our breath on people who are just not going to change. They're, you know, circular logic. They just keep going back and saying, well, it's my freedom, it's whatever. I'm free.
Vaccine!
Whoa. They really want us to get vaccinated.
Three days later.
One drop of this and I'll be hot up. Oh, the socks. Finally, these goddamn socks are here. Yeah, baby. Oh yeah, it's about time. And hey, what the fuck? Get the vaccine? A sock company? Get vaxxed? A sock company? Oh, I'm gonna give them a piece of my mind.
Hey, suckheads! Was it George Soros, a round earther, or the lizard people that told you it was gonna be a good idea to include a vaccine pamphlet in my sock package? No, thank you. I already have 13 months' supply of hydroxychloroquine and ketamine. That's the only horse medicine I need, because ain't nothing no way gonna make me get rid of my worms, who are the only thing right now that aren't blocking me on Twitter. Post, block, fuck, misinformation, shit! Well, outside of my reviews on Amazon, luckily I still have one safe space. A place where no one would ever talk about the vaccine. That's right, psytrance music.
Ah, fuck.
The psychedelic vaccine compilation was created via Spirit Architect sample pack competition to see who could come up with what. The best tracks were hand-selected by Mr. Spirit Architect himself for the compilation. There are a few repetitive sounds you hear here and there, but not really in a repetitive way. The artists all put a little bit of zing on each of the tracks, and there are some serious psychedelic monsters throughout the compilation. So let's get into it. Well, we should probably start off with track 1, Ripping Reality by Rush. Let's have a listen to this track. Let's just stop right there. Everything's made out of CGI graphics, yet for some reason looks more real? Well, you're clearly on someone's payroll. Who is it? Zuckerberg? Gates? Musk? Who's paying you? Well, let's forget about the metaverse for a second, because the rest of this track jabs me into Psytrance land and renames the NRA into the MRNA.
Nah.
It's a festival stomper that swaps up the drum patterns faster than a hit of Madonna would swap up my gene sequence, and has a drop that would make a dance floor of hippies shout, "Fuck yeah!" louder than an Israeli getting their fifth booster shot. The track was a great opener and was the reason I decided to keep digging into this release. Saiga's Parallel Universe swells my testicles up bigger than Nicki Minaj's cousin friend in Trinidad.
Guy, hate it when my testicles swell up bigger than Nicki Minaj's cousin friend in Trinidad.
We get a bunch of change-ups throughout the track before it picks one solid direction to deliver us one glorious finale. A pretty rock-hard track that kept my attention and made me say, "Shot, yeah? I'm gonna keep digging into this release." Atisha and Quantum Fracture fuck around for a few minutes before giving us a big hit of Malady, then offer us a moment to learn about superposition. I didn't personally indulge in any of the information because I'm too busy with all of this other information. It's telling me that hydroxy whatever and ivermectin something or other isn't actually the gel paste embodiment of Satan himself? What?
Hey, shut your mouth! Shut your fucking mouth!
Oh, whoa, whoa, just relax, man. I'm just reading science, dude.
No, it isn't safe! Let me save you! Another death. Another body. I'd grown numb to the growing piles of bodies. They said this one had 27 bullet holes throughout it. I hadn't seen this parent yet. One thing was for sure. It wasn't no lambda. It was alive. Me. He needed a vaccine. ASAP. Vaccinate this, bitch. Another day. Another life saved. No one said being healthy was easy.
The track has a lot of moments on it that seem like waiting periods for the next big moment. Now, the moments are all worth it. It has some of the most consistent melodies on the album. My only very fair and reasonable critique is that some of those waiting periods could have had a little bit more effort put into them than Johnson & Johnson's best efforts. Because everyone should be able to do better than Johnson & Johnson. Species of the Universe by Hypermode takes me into space, blasts me past Andromeda 9, through the Crab Nebula, and into AstraZeneca. It's quite nice here. There's no coughing, no wheezing, and a lot of elderly people.
So many elderly people.
We don't need to worry about personal hygiene here. We don't need to wash our hands, sanitize, or respect anyone's personal space.
Cause we're healthy.
This is perhaps one of my favorite tracks on the compilation. The kick comes hard and fast, and every moment is filled with psychotic, novel zoonotic sounds, which are guaranteed to create some pretty confusing curves on some of these graphs. Now, there's no mandates for you to enjoy this track. Shit, dog. There's hardly any social pressure either. Do what you want. It's fine by me. But if you don't enjoy One Punch's heavy-hitting black hole psytrance monster, then I'll be left no choice but to come there and show you what a real vaccine looks like. Regular earbuds won't do the pumping antibodies of this track any justice. A big pair of festival speakers would help this track crackle and super spread itself out over the airwaves while it shoots through you with those lasery zaps of power. It uses that sample for the longest amount of time, which is great, because that sample is possibly the hottest sample in this sample pack of samples. Beirut pounds you in the face with a big full-on kick drum faster than a virus could have theoretically leaked out of a lab. For the main act, he darkens things up, swaps up the atmosphere and connects a few spike proteins to your Omega T-cells, creating a dark storm of energy.
And a lot of angry people!
And then just like a booster, he does it again. Flawlessly taking you into psychedelic bouncy land. Unfortunately though, we need to cancel this track for making me want to start asking questions. I wish it didn't have to be this way. It's a great track and I truly am gonna miss it. But it's in the hands of the responsible crowd of Twitter now. It's got to go.
Actually, you could just like not post that and then no one would get cancelled. I don't have a choice.
Now, just a quick ad break from the lads over at Pfizer, who are doing their part to get us back out there onto the streets.
Brought to you by Pfizer.
Pfizer, bringing back chaos, street fights, lewd public drunken behaviour, college students behind dumpsters, and aggressive boys. Pfizer! You think hospitals are overloaded now? You just wait until nurses get sick of helping all these bruised up beefy boys and deliberately start another outbreak just to get back into lockdown. Pfizer, bringing you egotistical, bruised up beefy boys. Thanks to Pfizer's bare minimum efforts in creating an efficacious vaccine and their collusion with monopolistic asshole Bill Gates' failed COVAX program, which purposely prices poor nations out of the vaccine response so that new variants emerge in order to sell more vaccines and only kind of work, you just wait and see how long it is before you're in another one. I say 6 months. This year you'll be having Omicron for Christmas. More drugs for Pfizer! Pfizer! Getting you out of lockdown to get you back into lockdown. Neo Sharma next with the track Medicine Man. Don't be fooled by the name of this artist and track, because it implants multiple microchips in me, which surprisingly took my head out of the sand. I was not expecting that. Microchips ain't so bad.
Thank you, Neo Sharma and Bill Gates, great leaders and rulers of all.
Oh, weird. The track
helps me understand that I must comply.
Oh, what the fuck? The track.
Comply or leave. Comply or die.
Oh, no, that's not what I'm trying to say. What I'm trying to say is that
love your government like they love you. They love you.
Medicine Man is a great psychedelic track with lots of fun effects and wackadoodle sounds and bird tweets and lots of other things that are going on that make it a banger.
Damn, this microchip feels so good. Give me another hit.
Ooh, yeah, that's the good shit. That's right there. Nothing wrong with some self-vaccination.
Parasynthax's mind construction gives me no adverse side effects and therefore there's simply no need for an indemnity clause. Just trust me. It incubates asymptomatic clusters of transmissible droplets throughout the layers. And if it was administered in a doctor's office, you'd have to wait in the waiting area not for 15 minutes, but for 20 minutes, because this track is more dangerous than Dr. Anthony Fauci with a soup spoon and a bowl of boiling water in a Chinese bat cave. It's time for the second last track, Bunyan Groove by Atromna and Thalamus. It's almost over. Yeah, I've heard that before. The track. It's better than Pathogens and only a little bit worse than eradicating polio, but is a fuckload more interesting than listening to epidemiologists on the news for 18 months straight. It doesn't have to make sense. It doesn't have to solve the world's problems. It just has to sound good. And it blows that task out of the water. Actually, I should probably double check my sources. Fucking yep, that's a solid source. Completely compelling and wonderfully convincing. That's the truth. And it ain't my fault if it doesn't magically solve all of the world's problems, because these guys do have an indemnity clause. IAM Dingo conjugates subunits of toxoids in my viral vectors and attenuates immunoadjuvants, leaving me feeling great, quite frankly. The final track, Mesmerize, has a cool floating intro that quickly turns into arpeggiated full-on mayhem. There are some cool moments that come and go. The whole thing has a nice flow, and there are some really cool samples towards the final act. And that's the compilation, my friends. Now, I don't think anything here is particularly new or incredibly different. There was the 1918 flu, the Spanish flu, the swine flu, the bird flu. We've been here before. We just have more internet and more anger. Oh yeah, sorry. The album. It's not a groundbreaking redefining of psychedelic full-on psytrance. How could it be? It was made with prominent psytrance artist Spirit Architect's psychedelic sample pack. And who's even asking for this to redefine psytrance? Nobody! Big kudos to Spirit Architect for not only being able to convince a bunch of artists to use his sample pack to make some music, but also for that music being good enough to put on a compilation to release on a label. Wow! So good work to the artist as well. So if you're done arguing with people on social media about your opinions on the vaccine this way or that way, and trust me, I get it. It's fun. You don't have to explain that to me. It's fun to tell people what you think about the vaccine. It's fun to argue with strangers in other countries that are not affected by you whatsoever about the vaccine. It's fun to tell people that they have to get it or they're killing my grandma. And it's fun to tell people just to shut the fuck up because they're being manipulated by tyrannical governments who are using this as an opportunity to grasp more power. And it's fun to tell people that Pfizer has your best interests at heart and they just care about you. And it's fun to remind people that every single company out there making the vaccine has negligence cases against them because they clearly don't care about people. And it's fantastic to make other people feel morally inferior because they're not listening to the governments telling them what to do. And everyone knows that when you do what you're told by the government, you're a good person. And what could possibly be more rewarding than telling people who have watched their loved ones pass away from a deadly virus that this is all part of a pandemic instituted by the World Economic Forum as part of their depopulation Great Reset efforts? Nothing! There is nothing more rewarding than that! Trust me, I get it. It's so exciting. But if you're done with that, if you've had enough of it, then maybe it's time to listen to some cool fucking music. Maybe it's time to listen to Daiquiri Records. It wouldn't matter if Alex Jones had compiled it. It wouldn't matter if the FDA didn't approve it. And they probably don't. It wouldn't matter if Playing It Loud made Graph on TV News Network go up. And it probably does. All that matters is that it sounds good, and it's fun, and it's nice to hear in your ears. So what's the problem? Forget about the problem!
Why is he not in jail?
Why is Hillary Clinton not in jail? Why are all of these pedophiles that are demanding you all to listen to their rules, why are they not in jail? Are you insane? Are you crazy? I think all of you should be in a psych ward right the heck now.
I can't stand this quarantine. So Mr. Salmon, please get the vaccine.